This is part 144 of SQL Server tutorial. In this video, we'll discuss the difference between exec and sp_execute SQL. In SQL Server, we've got two options available to execute dynamic SQL. We can use exec or its full form execute function, or sp_execute SQL system stored procedure. We'll discuss this in detail in part 138 of SQL Server tutorial. The advantage of using sp_execute SQL is that with it we can create parameterized queries, which prevents SQL injection attacks and promotes cached query plans reusability. If you search on the web for the difference between exec and sp_execute SQL, you will see that many articles on the internet says using exec over sp_execute SQL has got these two problems. It opens doors for SQL injection attacks. Cached query plans may not be reused and leads to poor performance. While this is generally true, when we use codename function, it can prevent SQL injection attacks. And with SQL Server auto-parameterization capability, cached query plans reusability may not be an issue. We'll prove both these points in just a bit. But before that, let's understand what is exec in SQL Server. Exec, or its full form execute function, is used to execute dynamic SQL and has got only one parameter, that is the dynamic SQL statement that we want to execute. Let's look at an example now. Here we have a variable @fn of type nvarchar. We're using this variable to store the first name of the employee. And then we have another variable @sql, again of type nvarchar. We're using this variable to create our dynamic SQL statement. And then we are passing the dynamic SQL statement to the exec function to execute. So when we execute this code, notice we get employee whose first name is John. At the moment we are using exec, we can also use its full form execute. When we execute this code, we get exactly the same record. Now if you look at the way we are building our dynamic SQL statement here, we are building it by concatenating strings, which is dangerous because it opens doors for SQL injection attacks. Now what if someone sets this first name variable to something like this? Look at what we are doing here. We are first closing the single quote that we have opened here. So the query will be select *from employees where first name equals empty string. And then we are issuing another SQL command, drop database salesDB, which is going to drop this salesDB database. And then we have another single quote left here. So to comment that, we're using these two characters. So let's execute this and see what happens. But before that, let's actually print what we have in this variable @sql. Look at the command that is present in this variable @sql. select *from employees where first name equals empty string, and then we are dropping the database salesDB, and then we are commenting out anything that is left after that. So let's execute this code and see what happens. Now at the moment salesDB database is still there, but if I refresh databases folder, look at that, salesDB is gone. So this code is prone to SQL injection attacks, but we can prevent SQL injection attack by using this code name function while still using exec. So let's pass this @fn variable to code name function, and using the second parameter of this function, I'm going to specify single quote as the delimiter, which will wrap the value that we have got in this @fn variable in another pair of single quotes, treating all that as a value for this first name column. If this doesn't make sense at the moment, don't worry, we are going to print what we have in this @sql variable, and that should make it clear. Since we are using codename function, we don't have to open the single quote here, and similarly we don't have to close it here either. So let's print what we have in this @sql variable. Look at that, select *from employees where first name equals, so whatever we have specified as the value for this @fn variable, all that is wrapped in another pair of single quotes, so treating that as a value for first name column. Since we don't have an employee with such a first name, the result set will be empty, but salesDB database will not be dropped. Let's prove that. Let's create a new database. Let's name this database salesDB. So we have our sales DB created here. Let's comment the print statement and execute the SQL. Notice within the result set, we don't have any records, but when we refresh the databases folder, we still have the sales DB database. So we are able to prevent SQL injection attack by using code name function while we are still using exec to execute our dynamic SQL statement. Along the same lines, cached query plans reusability also may not be an issue with SQL Server auto-parameterization capability. Let's prove that now. So what is auto-parameterization in SQL Server? SQL Server can detect parameter values and create parameterized queries on its own even if we don't declare them explicitly. This is called auto-parameterization. However, there are exceptions to this. Auto-parameterization in SQL Server comes in two flavors, simple and force. We will discuss auto-parameterization in detail in a later video. Now, let's see what we already have in the plan cache by executing this command. We discussed this command in one of our previous videos, so I'm not going to go into the details of that. We have a lot in the plan cache. To keep things simple, let's clear everything that we have in the plan cache by executing this command, dbcc free proc cache. All right, now let's set first name to John. Let's execute this query now, and let's see what we have in the plan cache. So notice here, we have a query, select star from employees, where first name equals John, and beneath that we have a prepared statement. Notice here, we have an auto-parameterized query. So there's a parameter at one, that's the name of the parameter, and select star from employees where first name equals at one. And at the moment, look at the use counts of that parameterized query, it's one. Now let's change the first name from John to Mark. Let's execute the SQL. And let's again see what we have in the plan cache. And now, if you look at this prepared statement, notice the use counts has gone up by one. Okay, so it's reusing this auto-parameterized query. Similarly, if we set it to Steve, for example, execute that. And now when we select what we have in the plan cache, notice again the use counts for our auto-parameterized query has gone up again. So with this auto-parameterization capability of SQL Server, we are able to reuse the cached query plans. Finally, let's quickly summarize what we have discussed so far. If you use codename function, you can prevent SQL injection while still using exec. Cached query plan reusability is also not an issue while using exec, as SQL Server automatically parameterizes queries. It's always better to use SP execute SQL over exec, as we can explicitly parameterize queries instead of relying on SQL Server auto-parameterization feature or codename function. We know exec has got only one parameter, that is the dynamic SQL statement that we want to execute. As a result of that, it's not possible to create explicit parameterized queries using exec. So that's why use exec only in throwaway scripts rather than in production code. Thank you for listening and have a great day.